Let me show you how you can connect JotForm with GPT for AI. So let's jump into my desktop right now. Welcome to JotForm. My name is George, and today I'm going to show you how to connect JotForm with GPT-4, which is an AI engine from OpenAI. Now, be aware that you will need the API key from OpenAI to use this automation. Now, the idea of this is to connect with GPT-4, which is the latest version of AI as of this video. And once you have this connection, you can start your automations to auto-respond or use it for other things that you might want to automate. Now, let's get started with this, okay? So for this connection, we're gonna use JotForm, Pavli Connect, and OpenAI for GPT-4. Now, the idea is to use Pavli Connect as the bridge, so it makes a connection from JotForm to GPT-4. So for this, we're in the dashboard for Pavli Connect, and we're gonna get started with create a workflow. In this case, I'll call it JotForm GPT-4. Let's go ahead and create this, and it's gonna start the builder for the automation. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to need is choose JotForm. So this is going to be the trigger. The trigger is what needs to happen first in order to start the automation. And the trigger is going to be obviously JotForm when someone submits a form. The trigger event is going to be a new response, and we're gonna use this webhook on our JotForm. So let's go ahead and copy this webhook. Now let's go into our JotForm dashboard, and we're gonna start with a new form, something really simple. Let's start from scratch, classic, and we'll add some basic elements just for testing purposes, but the full name, the email, and some long text right here, okay? So there we go. We're gonna go into settings, integrations, and we are going to search for webhook, okay? Here it is, let's go ahead and select it. And the link that we just copied on Pavli Connect, we are going to use it here. Okay, so let's add the webhook there, complete the integration. There we go, it's ready and integrated. Now, be aware that on Pavli Connect, it's waiting for a webhook response. What it's trying to indicate is that it needs the form to be filled out once, so it knows what data needs to be captured. So let's fill it out once, let's go into publish, let's open in a new tab, and let's fill it out with some demo information. Okay, here it is. Now, let's fill it out with some basic info, and I'll just write in my name. Okay, some basic questions and my email. Let's go ahead and submit it, and let's go into Pavli Connect. And here we go, we just received the response. You can see we're gonna grab a lot of data from the form, not just the fields that we filled out, but we also get the submission ID, the username, the type, etc., the email, and we can use all of this for our automations. Now, that's the first connection, that's the trigger. Now, we need to do an action. Now, the action, well, we wanna connect with ChatGPT, GPT-4. So, let's search for it, and here it is, ChatGPT, we're gonna select it, and the action event is ask ChatGPT. Let's go ahead and connect. Now, in this section, we need to add a new connection if you haven't connected previously. So when you add a new connection, we are going to need the API key, and that's going to be over here on your OpenAI dashboard. So you go into your personal name here, you're gonna go view API keys, and you're going to have a list of APIs. You're gonna create a new secret key, and once you have it, we are going to use it here on Pavli Connect to make the connection. In this case, I've previously connected, so I'm just gonna use the one I have already. Now, right now by default, it's GPT 3.5 Turbo. Now, like I said, we wanna connect with GPT-4, which is the latest AI version as of this video. To do this, I can go ahead and click on here, but I don't have the option. But if I enable map, that means I can use my own prompt. So in this case, I am going to switch it to GPT-4, which is how it's designated as the model, okay? So that way it knows it's going to use that engine. And in the prompt is where we want to start our automation. What do you want to do with GPT-4? So in this case, you could say, respond to this message in a friendly manner, and it's gonna be mapped to the field where it has the long text. Now you can map this to wherever whatever section you need. So I just typed this in for demo purposes, and now I can save and send a test request. So it's gonna start the automation, and it's gonna enable this to contact GPT-4 to do the automation. Okay, here we go. You can see that it finished the automation, and we have the response right here. This response is going to be based on the prompt that we just used. So see, we got all this message thanks to GPT-4. we go a little bit longer. It's actually even longer. So we have all this message because we asked it in the request, respond to this message in a friendly manner. And obviously the request was, I need to know more about JotForm. And we had this response about JotForm. See how easy that was? Now, we can trigger this to do an automation to auto-respond or do other things with it. Now we can go ahead and continue the automation and, for example, respond to whoever is submitting the form via this AI. We can use our own SMTP or Gmail or whatever automation you want to use for this. Even send it to a CRM or any use case that you want to give it. But that is how you're going to connect JotForm with GPT-4, which is the latest version of AI as of this video. Well, we thank you all for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and hit that little bell notification to get notified when new videos come out. And that's a wrap.